in the early 90s, I had an opportunity to meet the official reenactor for playing the part of George Washington at Valley Forge. It was a special time to get to visit with him. He is obviously the first president, and you have a great affection for him.
Absolutely. I believe he embodies what our military embodies. He was obviously the first commander of the American armies. The uniform I wear, the colors of that uniform, are the colors that he selected. He embodies the three words that really hold, that's the glue that holds our military together, regardless of branch: duty, honor, and country. And we all have sworn, officer and enlisted alike, to protect and defend the Constitution from all enemies, foreign and domestic, something that he presided over, something that he passed, something that lasts forever, and we hope that everyone will embrace it, read it, and understand it, and make sure we never drift away from what the Founding Fathers believed. We all have heroes, but many of them are fleeting in nature. Our Founding Fathers, the men who signed the Declaration of Independence, men like George Washington, Alexander Hamilton, John Adams, those men have stood the test of time. Their beliefs were based on a strong Christian value, and those beliefs stand just as true today as they did 236 years ago.
If he were here today, and you're having studied the man, what do you think he would say the people need to be doing to restore this republic?
Well, I think you just said it. I think he would say we need to restore the republic, that we need to put God back in the public square, that we need to put God back into the classroom. You know, it'll be 50 years this year, in 2012, when the Supreme Court took religion out of our schools. And 50 years later, we see an amoral nation. And it's only because our young people don't understand what morality is. They have no idea upon what morality is based, the belief systems that made this country great.
2012, countdown now to an election in November, and it is for the people to finally rise up and exercise their vote to start that process, turning it around again.
One of the wonderful things about America is that we change leadership peacefully. We do it through a process of voting, one man, one vote. That is a God-given right. It is a responsibility for every man and woman to exercise. And I ask people to become informed about the candidates, become informed about the issues, and whatever you do, please, please register and please, please vote. That is so important to our republic.
Your thoughts about Dr. David McCallum?
Dr. David McCallum is a great patriot. He's a man of honor. He's a man who believes in what he does. He's a man who serves not only the people as a surgeon, as a great neurosurgeon, but he's also a man who serves this nation by putting this kind of an event on. I can't say enough about Dr. McCallum. He's very much like Dr. Franklin. He's like so many other patriots in the past who have spent their, not only their sacred, dedicated their lives and their fortunes, but to the great nation that they live in and that has made them prosperous, and sharing that. So Dr. McCallum is a wonderful man.
In closing, you are again?
Dr. Rich Swier. I'm a lieutenant colonel, United States Army retired, and I'm just proud to be here.
She's here to talk to us about the Jewish perspective on liberty and justice. Thank you, Elizabeth.